Hi, friends.
Do I look a little bit creepy? I'm sitting in my dark car, but I just
thought it'd be fun to do a nighttime in the van, coming alive at Christmas. I just left the coffee shop where I wrote my blog post for tomorrow, today as you're watching, and I got so excited as I was typing. I spilled coffee all over the blog post, so as I write in there, too bad it's not scratch and sniff. Today's topic, Mighty God. Isaiah 9 goes through the names of Jesus that was proclaimed, like, he's coming, and these are the things he's going to be. Yesterday, we talked about how he's a wonderful counselor. Today, Mighty God. And my pastor preached on that Sunday, and just that powerful reminder that the same God who parted the Red Sea is working in your life, and how we can just be still. As God told the Israelites, be still, I will fight for you. And today, the mighty God is fighting for you. He is fighting all of hell's darkness to bring you life. And he came, the mighty became meek in a manger so that you can experience a relationship with him. And tonight, the moon, you can't see it right now in my car, but the moon is just stunning. And the thought that the same hands that flung the stars and the moon were scarred for me and you. And then the mighty God made himself meek enough to hang on a cross. So whatever you're struggling with or need a reminder of today, come alive at Christmas knowing he's mighty. He is so big and so mighty. There's nothing he can't do. And sometimes that is hard when we're wondering, okay, why didn't he move in this situation or that? And if you're in that spot, let me just encourage you to cry out to Jesus and question the questions from your heart. And you may not get an answer here on earth, but what I love is our mighty God listens and hears, and he is working a story for his glory. We can just really rest on that today. Come alive with the mighty God today.